Hello and welcome back to Proactive, where I'm talking to Richard Williams, who's the CEO of Cornish Metals. Richard, it's been such a long time since we last heard from you. How have you been keeping?
Very busy and nice to be back, Thomas. Good to be here today.
It's great to have you back on. And I think it really has been 6 or even 7 months, and there has been a lot of work going on at the South Crofty tin mine. So perhaps you can tell us a bit about it.
Well, yes, we've got two big projects going on parallel at the moment at site. The major one is building a water treatment plant, which we are coming to the finishing line on. We expect to be commissioning that through August and start dewatering the mine end of August. And at the same time, we've been conducting a feasibility study and a drill program to collect samples from the various parts of the mineral resource here that we can use for ore processing technology, ore sorting, paste backfill studies. So that's all going very well.
Fantastic. And I believe you've also had your AGM recently. How was the feedback you received there?
All of our shareholders are very happy. All of the motions that we put forward at the AGM were all approved unanimously. So that was positive. You know, I think the main thing is we've got the funding to get this thing keep going here. Our big shareholder, Vision Blue Resources, very happy with the progress today.
Brilliant. And you are actually on site at this very moment working away. So what's your primary focus at the moment, would you say, Richard?
The primary focus is obviously to complete the construction and commissioning of the water treatment plant and to commence dewatering of the mine. That's a major milestone for the project. And it allows us to get access into the underground workings and obviously open up the mineral resource for mining in the future. At the same time, we're trying to complete as much of the feasibility study this year and into early next year as possible, so that we're in a position as soon as possible to make a project finance decision next year.
Zooming out a little bit now, Richard, you obviously last spoke to us at the beginning of January, and we've had an entire half year since then. So just your personal feeling on how you think the first half went overall.
Well, from my perspective, it's been tremendous. I was looking at some photographs the other day, and we put some of these up at the post-AGM presentation to shareholders. And late November, early December last year, we had just a concrete pad just off to the side of the office down here, which is now the site of the water treatment plant. As I said, the plant itself is very impressive. If anybody's interested, they can go to the website and see some photographs of it. All of the large mechanical aspects have now fully installed, and it's just a case of wiring everything up and connected to the drivers for the pump in itself. We completed the installation of the first pump to 360 meters below surface in the cook's kitchen shaft, and the second pump is on site, and that's currently being installed now. So everything's coming together at the right time. Exciting times here, but a lot going on.
And what do you think you can realistically achieve by the end of the year, Richard?
We've got a few things in the works between now and the year end. Obviously, the big one is start the dewatering of the mine and demonstrate to the market that what we've calculated, it's all going to work. And we'll see the levels in the mine water going down steadily over the balance of the year once we start pumping. We'll have updates on the various aspects of the feasibility study as they come through. So we published some assays earlier this week from what we call number 4, number 8, and Ross Gear loads, which came back with some, as we'd expect, some very high-grade tin mineralization. So it really demonstrates that the tin mineralization is there beneath the old workings, and the mine does have a very positive future ahead of it. We expect to have an updated mineral resource estimate for hopefully by the end of September. And that would obviously feed into the feasibility study as well. And we're also looking at potentially doing some drilling on a new discovery that we announced in January. That was probably the last time we spoke, the Wide Formation, which is a brand new discovery in a very well-established mining camp, which has, we believe, some very large-scale potential.
Great. And just finally, before I let you go and get back on with all that hard work, Richard, is there anything else you'd just like to get off your chest and make clear to any existing or potential shareholders today?
No, everything's going as well as we could expect. I think it's been a tremendous achievement for the team down here to see the growth in the number of people we've got employed. A year ago, we were about 8 people on site. Now we're about 50 people working on various aspects of the project. So exciting times, and it's nice to see that all of the people we've employed are local people from Cornwall. So it's nice to have that contribution to the local community.
Absolutely. Well, it's great to hear it, Richard, and we really appreciate you taking the time to come and talk to us at Proactive, and hopefully we'll catch you again at some point, hopefully before Christmas.
That's great. Thanks again, Tom.